Welcome to Cleveland Heights City Council meeting. It's a special meeting, Wednesday, March 24th, 2021. This meeting is called to order. Mrs. Himmelein, please call the roll.
Dunbar.
Present.
Hart.
Here.
Russell.
Here.
Saren.
Here.
Stein.
Present.
Unger.
Here.
Six present, Your Honor, we have a quorum.
There are no members to excuse tonight. Next, we're going to move right away. Personal communication received from citizens via electronic mail. Before we begin reading this portion, which is going to be lengthy, tonight's meeting will solely focus on the MetroHealth expansion, which will help them provide vital services to our community while adding over 100 well-paying jobs. We will now have personal comments read into the record by our staff. There are over 100 to be read, and there is a great deal of repetition and in many cases, inaccuracy regarding the removal of trees. So just to clarify now, before we begin reading the comments, in order to put in the critical ambulance drive, Metro will be using 0.73 acres, that's less than an acre, 0.73 acres of the 7 treed acres of their own property. They are committed to being environmentally sensitive and have an arborist who will work with our city forester. I have asked Metro to make a brief presentation afterwards to clarify some of the information. Thank you. Mrs. Himmelein?
You're muted.
You're on mute, Amy.
I should know that. We're going to do kind of a round robin. So first, Mary Trupo is going to read, and then Jim Lambden, and then Susanna, then myself, and then we'll repeat and get through all the comments that way.
Okay, I'll go ahead and begin. We have names, but no addresses. So I'll just read first from Susan Squires. I became aware only recently that MetroHealth is proposing to remove almost 1 acre of mature trees in the severance area for parking. I strongly oppose this. We are all aware of the need for restoration of the green canopy in Cleveland Heights. The removal of precious older trees for parking, which is already available, is not okay. Please insist that MetroHealth further investigate how to utilize close by parking spaces that are currently going unused. Do not allow destruction and removal of important mature forests when there are other viable options. Sue Jansen, Save Milliken Woods. They are irreplaceable, Cleveland Heights treasure. Gabriella Leonardo, it was brought to my attention that the destruction of almost an acre of trees in the Milliken Woods adjacent to Severance is being considered by Cleveland Heights City Council. It is my belief that Metro Hospital should use the vast parking lot at Severance to serve their needs. Why would old growth trees get cut down to create additional parking when there are several spaces across the street? I was born in Cleveland Heights and have remained here for several reasons. One reason being the balance of green space to develop space. I urge you to protect our existing green spaces to help maintain an environmentally conscious city. Jody and Ernie Molnar, we strongly oppose allowing any of the wooded area adjacent to Severance to be clear cut for additional parking. There is adequate parking available at that location directly across the Ring Road. MetroHealth should be instructed to make appropriate arrangements with the property owners for use of spaces if needed. Safety measures could be put in place for employees and patients who need to cross the street. Employees and patients at MetroHealth's main campus, at University Hospital's main campus, and at Hillcrest all have to deal with busy streets, far busier than the Severance Ring Road, on a daily basis. If Metro is concerned that future development could remove the availability of those parking spaces, they could use the money earmarked for destruction of the forest and installation of parking spaces to instead purchase a portion of the existing parking lot, thereby protecting their use of the spaces. If needed, they could fence it off and even install a pedestrian bridge. Excess parking at Severance is an eyesore, and drivers of semis have claimed it as parking space for their rigs. They should be directed to one area in the unused space, maybe all over by Walmart. destroying more of the tree canopy for parking spaces, which may or may not be used, is creating another impervious surface and further contributing to water runoff, is an unsound, ill-considered idea when so much unused asphalt is close at hand. Gus Kios, I'm writing to you as one of a significant number of Cleveland Heights residents who are opposed to the clear cutting of the woods behind MetroHealth's facility to make way for 80 parking places. You know the argument. Trees give oxygen, trap carbon, and they reduce water runoff compared to asphalt. I would urge caution with clear cutting the woods. Once they are gone, it is forever. Rather, let's put in temporary crossing lights to the ample parking spaces across the road for employees. The council should table this for 30 days, during which MetroHealth, City Council, Development Department, and city residents can have a joint meeting to discuss alternatives, to clear cutting the woods to create new parking spots. If Cleveland Clinic and UH could inconvenience their employees by parking them remotely while creating better solutions, why can't MetroHealth and Cleveland Heights? This one is a little lengthy from Janet Kramer. I recently learned of plans to destroy old growth forest adjacent to the severance lot for MetroHealth's use as a parking lot and want to voice my strong opinion against this decision. It is beyond foolish. It is short-sighted. It represents an unnecessary creation of more impervious asphalt at the expense of life-protecting trees. Trees are not expendable anymore. They clean the air, they cool the atmosphere, their root system filters water. Study after study demonstrates the health-giving and safety-promoting virtue of trees. And then she references three different websites. One is the state of South Carolina, one is southernforests.org, and the other is NPH Online Library. The one study that was done to supposedly justify the need for parking lot spaces for the MetroHealth expansion provided the exact opposite. There is no need. For your reference, she references a Cleveland Heights site / MetroHealth parking - memo. I suggest you look outside the bubble of your narrow-minded council and consult environmental experts, advocates for keeping the trees, who could propose alternatives to destroying old growth trees before you make preposterous one-sided decision. Once old growth trees are killed, there is no reversing that decision. I've been reading several proposed solutions to the so-called risk of people having to cross the Severn Circle Road. Creating a crosswalk with blinking yellow lights is viable, like the one on Lee Road near Cedar and by Boulevard School. Or put in a stoplight that turns red upon a pedestrian's press of the button, as the one at Taylor and Washington has been for years. I believe a bridge or tunnel probably would cost too much and have its own inherent risks, such as wheelchair-bound person navigating stairs or steep ramps. Someone mentioned changing the actual path of Severn Circle Road. That would not be that difficult or expensive. Direct Severn Circle to dip closer towards the current strip mall buildings, thus allocating the additional 80 or so parking spots to the metro side of the road. Those parking spaces are always unused anyway. If they currently belong to the owner of Severance, then negotiate a long-term lease or require new MetroHealth behavioral health buildings to have underground parking or build a parking garage on one of the lots to increase the number of parking spaces. There surely is more than one viable solution that does not involve killing valuable trees. The dilemma requires creative, outside-the-box thinking, and I suggest you take the time required for due diligence to come up with a more satisfactory solution. The rushed and hushed nature of this decision appears to be a front for vested interests, and frankly, it stinks. I urge you to vote no on the proposal as it stands. John Mellorano. I have learned that Metro wants to cut down trees at Severn Center to add additional parking. I feel there should be another way to supply more parking with so much vacant space available at Severn. I oppose the cutting down of mature trees for this purpose. We are the city of trees. Please do not approve the plan. Wendy Kokofsky. We are strongly opposed to cutting down trees to create more parking for the MetroHealth facility at Severance Center. The world does not need more parking lots or larger parking lots. There is a huge parking lot directly across the street from their facility, which could be used instead. Surely arrangements could be made to do so. If this is deemed unworkable by MetroHealth, move the roads so that their existing parking lot extends into what is now a street. It is unconscionable that the building, the Planning Commission, and our elected council members would agree to this. Tom Kakowski, hope I'm saying that even remotely correct, and this one's a little lengthy as well. Stop the war on trees. Cleveland Heights is missing a golden opportunity. Severance is thousands of square feet of available parking space and medical office space. Retail is not coming back. Have Metro take over substantial parts of the Severance medical functions. Doctors and other medical service will follow. The former shopping center can become thriving medical center. Since the lockdown, I've been walking the dog twice a day for about 5 miles a day, weather permitting. I've been listening to the symphony of chainsaws cutting down trees. The trees are why we moved to Cleveland Heights. I don't think I've seen a single replacement tree planted in the past year. Cleveland Heights is starting to look like one of those undesirable new development communities that was plunked down in a cornfield. We need to maintain the trees we have and replace the loss. Cleveland Heights needs to initiate a 2-for-1 replacement requirement. We are so far behind, it's the only way to again become a tree-friendly community. The parking lot at Severance is getting scary. There are semis parked all over everywhere. To drive across the parking lot puts me in fear of being T-boned by a vehicle coming from between the trucks or trailers. I'm ready to start driving further out of Cleveland Heights to avoid the parking lot. Encourage Metro to build the extra facilities in the semi parking lot and connect the complex by covered skywalk walkways like the Cleveland Clinic main campus on Prospect. The complex could eventually connect to the old Walmart and other retail space, creating a magnificent med complex. Cutting down trees for short-term gains is going to kill the long-term viability of Cleveland Heights. We are the green city by the blue lake. There are concrete jungles all around vying with each other to be cheaper, not better, not greener. This will compromise the character and future of Cleveland Heights. If the city does capitulate, require Metro to replace each lost tree with 2 or 3 trees of 2.5 to 3 inch caliber. From what I've seen, too many homeowners will not give the tree lawn trees a drop of water in a drought. There are dead tree lawn trees all around. They need to sponsor a youth program to drive water carts around watering the stressed tree lawns in the summer, along with tree planting youth program. Yes, machinery can dig to plant faster, but Cleveland Heights youth needs the opportunity to work. Deny the cutting down of treed areas and require the asphalt jungle to be repurposed into useful space. Lynn Mensch, I'd like to submit a public comment regarding MetroHealth's plan at Severn Circle. City Council members, please do not approve the destruction of the woods to make room for more parking. There is plenty of unused parking at Severance. I've been a resident of Cleveland Heights for over 30 years, and I have walked around Severance hundreds of times. It is not dangerous to cross the street, and there is more wildlife living there than most people realize. There is no reason to allow this. There is also a lot of confusion around when this will be discussed and why the public comments were already taken down for the March 22nd meeting. Rebecca Horder, the Cleveland Heights Master Plan sustainability goals include protecting and expanding the tree canopy, especially at Severance. Approving the project as it is with no stipulation to save the trees directly violates the city's stated policies. The trees in the mature legacy, number two, the trees in this mature legacy forest are irreplaceable. Three, trees filter air and stormwater and reduce runoff. They produce oxygen, cool the air, and sequester carbon. Their presence increases the value of our real estate. Four, the trees slated for destruction constitute the densest and healthiest part of the forest. Five, the woods have suffered from years of reckless development with the demolition of one small segment after another. Further destruction would degrade them as an ecosystem, depriving our community of the benefits ecosystems provide. 6, this ecosystem is a vital asset to our city and should under no circumstances be destroyed or degraded. These few old growth forests that remain must be preserved at any cost. Cleveland Heights has been designated a tree city, and the existence of these trees play a major impact in keeping our planet green and healthy. This is important for animal and human physical and mental health. And I believe I'm turning it over to Jim.
Correct. This comment is from Michael Windorf. Please save the trees in nature at Severance. This land is precious for life. We don't have much of it left and we need to protect it. There's a giant parking lot empty across the street. A little walk is health. Please vote down the removal of an acre of 100-year-old trees and its wildlife for more parking space. This comment is from Raymond Lesser. There are 700 acres of mostly unused parking lot across the street from the MetroHealth Center at Severance. There's absolutely no reason to destroy an acre of mature forest to build yet another acre of parking. I'm sure that the City of Cleveland Heights and the MetroHealth authorities can figure out a way to buy or lease a part of the parking lot that already exists at Severance. The city can easily facilitate this happening and build the necessary and traffic signals. Please vote against this project until the necessary adjustments can be made. This comment is from Joanne Siegel. Please do not allow MetroHealth to cut down any trees to make way for a parking lot. There is a gigantic lot across the road from them. They can lease out the space and if necessary, put in a crosswalk and a light. There's absolutely no need to destroy any landscape to do this. I am not against their expansion plans or development in general in Cleveland Heights, but there is no logical excuse to allow the destruction of mature trees if there is a reasonable alternative. There's definitely a reasonable alternative. The study done determined that there's absolutely no need for additional parking spots, even with the expanded services. They suggested that the two lots that they already have should be better maintained. The stripes need to be redone so patrons can tell where the parking spots actually are. And they suggested that employees park in the lots further away from the building. They even recommended clever markings, reminding them that the longer walk will have health benefits. It seems to me that city officials wish to allow the hospital to cut down the trees to make room for more parking spots. That also will not be maintained. What then? Give them even more spots. According to the study, they do not even project the need to use any of the spots across the road. This comment is from Penny Allen. I urge you not to approve the MetroHealth plan to raise 40 acres of mature forest from the Severance property for parking. We need to preserve these tracts of mature woods wherever it's feasible in our communities for their value in sequestering carbon, holding runoff, providing bird nesting and wildlife habitat. Easing the heat islands of surrounding buildings and asphalt and providing mental health benefits of being able to view green space. There's no reason to lose more of those benefits when there's already plenty of parking space at Severance Center that could be made convenient with a stoplight and a crosswalk. This comment is from Edward Galfott. As a resident of Milliken neighborhood and a 61-year resident of Cleveland Heights, I'm asking more like demanding that the City Council does not grant MetroHealth the right to cut down the remaining trees on the Severance site near them, but instead uses the acres of open parking already present and unused to fit MetroHealth's parking needs. The idea of destruction of these trees is ludicrous and unnecessary. Plenty of unused blacktop already exists in that area, so yes, in fact, I demand City Council denies this proposal. This next comment is from Patricia Hanavan. I support the building of MetroHealth's new addition and behavioral health center. It's a much needed facility. However, I hope that council will not approve the removal of the woods at the edge of the property. Cleveland Heights needs more, not fewer trees. Surely nearby parking could be provided by leasing from Severance Center. This comment is from Elizabeth Mather. Please require MetroHealth to utilize existing paved area for their needed parking at Severance Town Center rather than cutting existing tree cover. The tree cover in this area is part of the reason we choose to buy a house in this neighborhood. Also at a time when many efforts are underway to expand tree canopy coverage to counteract urban heat island effects and reduce storm drainage and to function as a carbon sink. It is necessary to consider the cost benefit to the neighborhood and our environment when accepting or rejecting this issue. Please be forward thinking and preserve this tree cover. It may not be ecological pristine, but it serves far more uses intact than a parking lot would. This comment is from Suniva Collins. MetroHealth proposed expansion of Severance. The removal of nearly an acre of trees to create approximately 80 parking spots east of proposed buildings is not acceptable to me as a lifelong Cleveland Heights resident. It has always been a point of pride to live in a community that values our mature trees and canopy. It's embedded in our logo and reflected in many of the names of our streets and parks. The environmental impact of this aspect of the development needs to be addressed. I urge that other alternatives be evaluated and considered. Surface parking is a wasteful reason to remove more trees. So much of Severance has already been paved over and it's not even being used. Isn't there a way to lease, rent, or purchase parking that's already been developed? This comment is from Carla Rottenberg. All over the world, people park their cars and cross the street to get where they are going every day of the week. Even people living in Cleveland Heights do this. To cut down mature trees forming part of a small but important forest system that absorbs stormwater and buffers adjacent residential areas from commercial activities ecologically wrong. To do so in order to create additional parking for a facility sitting on the edge of acres of unused parking surface is a product of unhealthy thinking. To get to work, to get to school, to go to their doctors, and yes, to visit their loved ones in the hospital, people commonly park and walk across streets, even heavily traveled streets, whence the Severance Ring Road is not. The addition of a traffic signal and painted crosswalk to make it even safer to cross that street, where necessary, on foot. I'm disappointed in the lack of common sense demonstrated by Cleveland Heights City staff, the Planning Commission, the Board of Control, and our City Council. It seems a new planning director was placed in an impossible position. These bizarre parking plans apparently were baked in to the design for the MetroHealth expansion before he arrived on the job. The overwhelming sentiment in Cleveland Heights is for the MetroHealth behavioral health expansion at Severance. Certainly I concur, and it is not MetroHealth's job to protect Cleveland Heights' environment. That is city government's job, and in this case, the job was not done right. However, MetroHealth, which has been a hero in developing its headquarters neighborhood on the near west side, could wear the hero's cape once again if it so chooses. It could commit to work with Cleveland Heights planning director, Namdar, which owns the Severance City property, and some resident experts in sustainable development to meet future parking needs without destroying part of our tree canopy. This would be good stewardship on the part of all involved, and that's what we need now. This comment is Thomas Morgan. With all the vacant land in an empty shopping mall, you think it's best to cut down a woods for parking? What utter nonsense during global warming. Hello, is there anyone in there? This comment is from Sarah Prentice Manella. I am greatly disturbed by the proposed removal of natural habitat and tree cover as part of MetroHealth's expansion. We already have so much displaced wildlife in Cleveland Heights, and the obvious solution is to utilize some of the available parking already sitting empty at Severance. Please consider a solution that reduces our unused empty paved spaces and preserving our forests. This comment is from Judith Hulse. Cleveland Heights must establish its place as a green community by leaving its trees and natural spaces alone. Commercial development can happen in a manner that respects nature first and foremost. We have everything to gain. Do not remove the Milliken Woods, take care of them. This comment is from Rebecca Slifer. Please keep trees. Removal of this asset is irreversible and irresponsible. Cleveland needs every tree we have. This comment is from David Narozny. Most Heights residents are happy to have the expanded medical facility presence at Severance. However, we can ask the architects to use a little bit extra effort to design what's needed on existing non-forest land. Once natural resources are gone, they are gone forever. Save the trees. This comment is from Karen Katzman. I urge you not to allow the trees around MetroHealth Severance campus to be cut down for their expansion. There are hundreds of existing paved parking spaces on the Severn Center property that could be acquired for MetroHealth's expansion parking needs. Let's keep that old growth area as is. It is an asset to the community and residents. There's really no need to cut down the trees as paved parking already exists. This comment is from Sam Barker. Cleveland Heights is known for its beautiful large trees and forested areas, but if we do not protect them, they will slowly disappear, bringing with them the unintended consequences of concrete sprawl, urban heat loss, loss of animal life, etc. Please protect the Milliken Woods and require a sensible evaluation by the city and MetroHealth to seriously explore options to use nearby underutilized parking. This comment is from Michael Morse. This is pretty long. I'm going to take a drink of water. Regarding the MetroHealth Severance expansion plans, just as the mental health of a person depends on their physical health, the mental health of a community depends on the health of its physical environment. In this time of worldwide environmental crisis, cities everywhere are working to improve their environments by protecting, expanding, and adding to their urban forests. This is a critical factor in making the city attractive to new residents and retaining existing residents. Cleveland Heights, as Tree City USA community, should be a leader in this effort. We must make every effort to avoid, reduce, and reverse the environmental impact of any development in our city. Public boards and meetings are conducted for the purpose of informing and protecting the public. We require that the public be given time to understand and respond to information presented in a meeting before any vote for approval may be given. I reject the emergency declaration for this project. An emergency is something like a tornado, blizzard, or pandemic. Meeting a developer's construction schedule is not an emergency. While I support the MetroHealth expansion in general, I'm sure it can be accomplished without destroying a wide section of trees on the borders of the parking lot. The proposal to remove the trees on the north side of the parking lot and to remove a 40-foot wide swath of trees on the east side of the parking lot is exactly the opposite of what our community should expect in any development. The damage does not stop there because the land bank provision enables even deeper presentation of the forest at a future time if someone decides more parking is needed. Our city officials should not accept this aspect of the proposal and should require a better solution instead. We are not talking about scenery here. These trees are part of the continuous corridor of urban forest stretching from South Taylor to the Milliken School and MetroHealth properties, and from there north to Mayfield Road. This ecosystem includes the one of the last remaining sections of the Dugway Brook watershed that has not been buried by urban development. This is a treasure we should cherish and preserve, not vacant land to be paved over. It is well known that a continuous canopy of forest, including a mixture of mature and young trees, is vital to protecting our air, our water, and the physical emotional health of our community. MetroHealth's plan to put a few saplings and traffic islands in a grassy field is no substitute for protecting the existing forest. I emphasize that I support the intentions of MetroHealth to expand its facility. This must be done in a way that does not damage our environment. And with that, Susanna, I'll turn it over to you.
David Shimatakara and Pandora Robertson. Dear Mayor Stein and Council, the expansion of MetroHealth's facility at Severn Circle might make sense to the city of Cleveland Heights for many business and service reasons, adding resource to the community. However, we add our names in questioning why that needs to be done at the expense of the irreplaceable natural resource of the green belt of Severn's Woods that the city is also entrusted to steward. We ask if in assessing the impact of this development, what other options have been seriously and properly considered? And if so, is there another way forward that advances all interests? If not, why not? Mary Frost, please do not cut down trees for the parking lot for Metro. Use the parking across the street. Put a light in and a crosswalk. Even a walking bridge would work, like the library has. Thank you. Jill Levin, there is a global climate emergency, no longer debatable, as we are already seeing the impact on weather and wildlife. We must do everything we can to protect ourselves as a species and as residents of this city, which includes preserving green space to improve the quality of the air around us and to allow for increased rains to have areas of absorption. The ecosystem too benefits from preserving the area. It is short-sighted and irresponsible to cut down existing trees to create another paved area, particularly when it is not needed given the available parking. There are other solutions to the issue of getting patients safely to where they need to be. A clearly defined crosswalk, shuttle buses, cars to transport for those who cannot walk the distance. Remove the possibility of cutting down the trees and you will find creative and workable solutions that don't further damage our already endangered environment. We rightfully expect and demand responsible, creative solutions from those in charge of this project. It impacts us all. Moshe Kove, I'm very concerned about the proposal to cut down a swath of healthy young forest of native species appropriate to their important hydrologic and ecological niche, and then come back in and replant the now clear-cut denuded area with a handful of red maple and a bunch of non-native evergreens, at least one of which our local deer consider M&Ms. How can this in any sense be considered a good land banking practice or good landscaping? The area in question is part of the headwaters of an already hugely compromised local stream, the Dugway. Whatever is done to any headwaters is paid for literally further downstream. This stream is already severely compromised through burying and culverting. When is enough? Our native oaks and maples play an important role in our hydrologic system by absorbing and holding huge amounts of water in their root systems without the need for so-called drainage improvements. The best land banking process for this parcel would be to leave it alone. The fact that there is so much unused surface already in Severance, which can be converted into additional parking instead of deforesting our local disappearing wetland, just makes this proposal even more frustrating. Catherine Michaels, please don't tear any more trees down. There is so much unused space at Severance. There's no need to develop more land. Get creative and take back some of the already dead space. Marty Bergman, I add my objection to destroying trees in our tree city. I have read many good options from our residents that could work. One option I did not see is to build a parking garage using the existing property. This would allow for a safe, enclosed, sheltered walkway for staff and visitors. Please review and consider all options. Alice Kessler, in regards to the new MetroHealth development, please utilize the existing parking at Severance instead of clearing out any of the forested area. Angelo Nicoletti Eaton, in regards to the MetroHealth Center, please, on behalf of the people that live here, utilize the 99% abandoned Severance Center and parking. Please do not destroy more of the little woods we have left out of convenience. This is one of the features that defines our neighborhood. Elizabeth Nicoletti Eaton, it would be a terrible shame to lose more green space in an area that has an overabundance of parking spaces. Cleveland Heights has limited areas where a person can admire our trees. Please do not let them destroy this space. There has to be a way to utilize the thousands of parking spaces across the street. To gain roughly 80 parking spaces is not worth the detrimental impact of removing more trees. Elizabeth Clow, I am in complete support of MetroHealth expanding their services to include behavioral health service. I am not in support of the city granting them permission to remove trees on the Severance property to create additional parking. There is currently an expansive parking area across the street at Severance Mall, greatly underutilized. Surely Metro should be given permission to utilize that parking lot. The city of Cleveland Heights and its residents have a long history of valuing and nurturing green space. Please vote against this request and assist MetroHealth with obtaining parking in the existing lot. Thank you for your stewardship and attention to this matter. Nancy Faulkner. In this time of climate change, preserving our trees and ecosystem is more important than ever. Severance has become a virtual wasteland of asphalt and empty stores. Why not save the trees and make a circle drive detour to wind through the empty parking lot? Then Metro Health Center could easily have ready-made treeless parking adjacent to their building and preserve a precious forested part of the city. Please think about the future and not the immediate need. Save the trees. Nathan Holsting, please find an alternative to destroying more of our natural space for the Severance Metro Health Addition. There's bound to be another option rather than deforesting more of the Forest City. Jana Fress, no, no, no to business as usual. It's time to use common sense. In the vast wasteland that is Severance Town Center, surely there is adequate available space for almost unlimited parking. Get a minivan to transport people if necessary, but don't add to the devastation of the Forest City. Kevin Horter. In this moment, we are facing unprecedented and very real threats of climate change. Deforestation is a proven cause of global warming. I grew up in Cleveland Heights and have lived all over the country and have always felt pride in that we are a community that cares for our natural resources and protects the environment. In recent years, we have decided that development, in my opinion, overdevelopment with short-term gains, has sent us down a road in which we as a community are turning our backs on the environment and our future generations at a time when the stakes are higher than ever. You can argue that this is a small piece of land and will have limited effect, but this is not true and is part of a larger pattern of eradicating a huge part of what has made this community special, our trees. We as a community need to reverse course on the trend of placing a premium on short-term profit at the expense of our forests, such as Oakwood, Legacy Village, and now this proposal. There are other viable options here that would spare our beautiful trees. I encourage you to consider each one of those precious trees and the ecosystem they support. Please think in the long term and what our own legacy will be when it comes to turning the tide. This is absolutely not the path we should continue on. It is not the environmentally minded Cleveland Heights I grew up in and that I decided to return to. Nydia Perez. Please save our trees in Milliken Woods surrounding Severance Town Center. There is so much empty space at Severance for parking. It would be a crime to take down any trees. Please consider the environment. One of the reasons why I bought my house in the Heights 30 years ago was because of the preservation of trees. Bob Kluse. I am grateful that Metro Health is expanding services in my zip code. I am disheartened that hundreds of trees will be sacrificed in the process. My sister worked in public relations at Sacred Heart Hospital in Eugene, Oregon. When they built a new 1 million plus square foot facility, one of the most appreciated amenities on the grounds was a stand of Douglas fir trees that enclosed 50% of the hospital perimeter. The trees were healing, she said. Please consider an alternative to removing some of our city's old growth forest. Certainly parking can be relocated easier than trees. Thank you. Rebecca Rourke, please keep the woods intact. It is a magnificent habitat for beautiful animals that enrich our lives. Please don't be short-sighted. Blaine Murray, please do not cut down the trees in the Milliken Woods for the Metro Health Project. There is plenty of parking near there already, and the woods are an important wetland. Joan Spurl, members of City Council. My dear brother John, who died of COVID in January, suffered terribly due to severe mental illness and a decade-long struggle with drug and alcohol addiction and periodic homelessness in Milwaukee. He also loved nature, trees, and plants. which brought him solace. So while I am pleased that MetroHealth will be bringing much needed service to our community to ease the suffering of others, I write now to express my dismay at the plan to destroy 40 feet of the Millican Woods. The research on the benefits of mature trees is clear for the watershed, air quality, and mental health. The research is also clear on how cutting off one part of a forest impacts the remaining forest. And again, research is clear that older, more mature trees are more beneficial. With the watershed issues facing our immediate Cleveland and wider Lake Erie, we simply can't afford to do this. When I visit Severance, what do I see? Concrete parking lots unused. There's absolutely no reason to add more parking spots for this facility with the abundance of impervious surfaces available. I urge you to reject this proposal to cut any trees. Why the haste on this decision? Be creative and consider the other options so readily visible. Richard Thompson. Work with MetroHealth to come to a compromise. Please don't chase another business looking to expand out of Cleveland Heights. Catalina Taba, the destruction of Millican Woods as part of MetroHealth's expansion should be avoided. There is plenty of empty eyesore area in Severance, and those areas already commercialized should be used instead. I oppose destroying Millican Woods. Aaron Manella, regarding resolution number 28-2021. I applaud the expansion of MetroHealth behavior health expansion. I am against further deforestation of Cleveland Heights open spaces without offset. The deforestation of Severance and along Warrensville Center with the Walmart and adjacent complex has left wildlife, deer and coyote and woodchucks and bird and smaller animal populations nowhere to go but the backyards of citizens. I would urge the council to either require MetroHealth to buy parking across the street in the 100 plus acres of parking and set up a light and crosswalk, or offset the deforestation with reforestation also across the street where the 100 plus acres of parking are. On a related note, I urge the council to take the abandoned and failed commercial blight that is the east side of Severance, where Walmart and other enterprises used to be under eminent domain, and regreen it as park and open space for wildlife and citizen use. Eric Fries. Wildlife resides in the wooded area near expansion plans for new MetroHealth facility. The area is already an ocean of asphalt. Paved paradise to put up a parking lot should not be our legacy. Sonia Miklowski, I am against removing mature forest wooded areas surrounding the MetroHealth campus. There is so much unused space that is already cleared and paved. There should be a solution to MetroHealth's increasing needs for parking that utilizes the existing parking without removing trees. We in Cleveland Heights value our trees and green space, and removing almost an acre of trees for parking when there is unused parking that is easily accessible is not within this community's values. Other options need to be explored. A footbridge or a designated crosswalk with a pedestrian controlled stoplight could be employed. This area already has so many vacancies and an excessive amount of paved parking for the amount of actual traffic to Severance. More is just uncalled for. We do not need to lose more of our precious tree cover. Please do not allow this.
Next comment is from Tony Thayer. Regarding the proposed MetroHealth expansion at Severance and the question of parking, the idea of clearing the Millican Woods in order to build a new parking surface next to the empty expanse of Severance parking is horrendous and in direct contradiction to the city's sustainability goals. Approving the project as it is with no stipulation to save the trees directly violates the city's stated policies, and council needs to act on this matter. We can do better than this. The woods are in a vital and already compromised ecosystem. They are an asset to our city, and their protection is an investment in our future. They should not be destroyed for any reason, but especially not for parking lot of all things. The nearby existing empty expanse of concrete and blacktop is already a grave problem for our community. Figure out a way to use it for MetroHealth. Be creative in thinking about traffic patterns and crosswalks. Yes, it may be temporary, should as every resident in the Heights hopes and prays, Severance ever be redeveloped in that space claim for some vibrant purpose. However, in that event, the city and MetroHealth would have ample lead time to plan for and even partner with a new developer. In 10 years, in 20 and 50, which do we want to be known for? Thriving natural resources, including protected mature trees and a robust tree canopy, which contributes to air and water quality, among other benefits, or an endless expanse of blacktop. Parking is a temporary issue. It is not worth clear-cutting 100-year-old trees. Our entire planet is facing climate crisis. This is real and permanent. You should have before you a local opportunity to contribute to a better way forward of being good by being good stewards of our land and resources. Take this opportunity. Carolyn Freer, please save the trees in Milliken Woods. We need to keep all the trees, and we need to keep planting new trees. Thanks. Resident of Cleveland Heights for 76 years. Keep all trees, please. Nicole Pritz, good afternoon. I urge you to reconsider deforesting the Milliken Woods for additional parking spaces for MetroHealth. There are acres of underutilized adjacent parking spots and multiple options, crosswalk, pedestrian bridge, etc., for making these spaces safely accessible. It is my understanding that analysis indicates that with better maintenance, the existing parking spaces are adequate for MetroHealth patients and employees, even with expanded services. The value of mature forests is priceless and irreplaceable. Landscaping with new plantings does not provide the same value, nor does it replace the existing ecosystem directly impacts the Dugway Brook. Please consider long-term effects on our community and citizens. The interests of big money entities should not be the primary concern. Mark Lefkowitz, dear MetroHealth and City of Cleveland Heights, we are writing to express concern over your plan to cut down 1.3 acres of mature trees on the eastern edge of your property at Severance Circle in Cleveland Heights for the purpose of expanding parking. First, we are patients of MetroHealth and appreciate your expanded presence in Cleveland Heights. It is why we are also troubled by this decision. As a healthcare institution that has committed to the National Eco District Plan on its main campus, we patients and residents have come to expect a real strong commitment to sustainability from MetroHealth. By not considering the option of auxiliary parking from the ample supply across the road on Severance Circle, in lieu of removing a forest for that parking, you and the city have demonstrated a lack of creativity and have underestimated your patients who would be willing to park and walk across the street. I know this is not the case for everyone, but surely a courtesy shuttle is a worthwhile consideration for those less able to make that simple walk. With your eco district on your main campus, you have shown an incredible willingness to be a creative placemaker for your community. We urge you to extend that vision to your satellite campus in Cleveland Heights. You can probably tell by the outpouring of support for the natural environment that a large group who lives in Cleveland Heights cares as deeply about preserving this forest as they do in wishing you success in expanding your operation at Severance. The two need not be mutually exclusive. We ask that you and the city reconsider all of your options before choosing the most expedient. The city agrees with us. It adopted in its 2019 master plan a key goal of the communities to preserve trees and green space. Let's show the region that it's possible to have a thoughtful, sustainable development that also satisfies a key tenant of the community which it serves. P.S. Today is International Forest Day. Did you know that the world is losing 10 million hectares of forest each year? About the size of Iceland, forests are crucial to stopping climate change. Susan Katie, please stop the loss of such an ancient stand of trees in our city. I have walked in these woods with grandkids and made an old growth forest lesson, rarely in the metro parking lot, more than half to two-thirds empty. Deborah Van Cleef, thank you for rescheduling the special city council meeting to enable the public to comment on a development project of such importance to our community. The new behavioral health unit at MetroHealth Severance location will provide much needed services. I welcome it wholeheartedly, along with, I am sure, most of my fellow residents. I am deeply concerned, however, about the hospital's intention to remove a 40-foot strip nearly an acre of the Milliken Woods to install new parking spaces along the east and north boundaries of the property. Hospital officials, Cleveland Heights planning commissioners, and members of the Board of Control refuse to seriously consider the possibility of an arrangement to use existing underutilized spaces across Severance Circle from the MetroHealth campus. I realize such an arrangement might be a bit complicated and would certainly require the installation of a crosswalk and a traffic light to keep employees and patients safe as they cross the road. But the area condemned to the axe is part of a mature forest with some trees over 100 years old. Their value as part of the ecosystem cannot be replaced by baby trees and islands strewn across the parking lot and patches of green space, even if they consist of native species. The sustainability goals in Cleveland Heights Master Plan require the maintenance of green infrastructure and the expansion of the tree canopy. The map of target areas for adding trees includes Severance. It hardly makes sense for the city to approve removing mature forests in opposition to its own master plan. The Milliken Woods are more than mere greenery. The trees there filter rainwater and help divert it from storm drains, sending it more slowly into the small stream that feeds Dugway Brook, which in turn takes it to Lake Erie. They remove pollutants from our air, provide us with oxygen to breathe, sequester carbon, and cool their surroundings in the summer. They provide habitat for many species of birds and insects. These few acres of woodland saved when the old estate was demolished to build the mall are a complete ecosystem and as vital as a part of our community as houses, stores, streets, and institutions. The new hospital unit will contribute to the health of the people in our community, but we cannot trade off a healthy environment for healthy people. We need both, and ultimately each depends on the other. The city should examine every proposed development, starting with this one, through the lens of sustainability. Finding an environmentally responsible resolution will take patience, creativity, and time, but it can be done. In 2012, the United Nations General Assembly proclaimed March 21st, the International Day of Forests. The 2021 theme is Forest Restoration, a Path to Recovery and Well-Being. Cleveland Heights should be a city where recovery and well-being is a goal, both its people and its natural infrastructure. Jeff Yore. It is especially galling that MetroHealth sits across the street from one of the county's largest and least utilized parking lots. There are more than 700 acres of parking inside Severance Circle, 70% of it unused. On Google Earth, Severance is an invisible eyesore from 10,000 feet, an embarrassment to our city. Surveys show that residents' number one concern is the condition of Severance. At the Planning Commission hearing this past Wednesday, a resident proposed that MetroHealth and the city work together on an alternative to destroying part of the forest. A hospital official responded that they do not own the parking area across the road and it might be developed in the future. He and members of the Planning Commission agreed that it would be irresponsible to require employees and patients to cross Severance Circle. They did not consider the possibility of installing a crosswalk and a traffic light. It is not irresponsible to clear-cut a 40-foot swath of forest. These woods are fragile and in need of protection. Encroachment will only make them more vulnerable. Moreover, tree removal violates the sustainability goals in the city's much-touted master plan, which calls for restoration of the tree canopy, with Severance included in the target area. How many residents would consider trees for parking an acceptable trade-off? One, the master plan sustainability goals call for protecting and expanding the tree canopy, especially at Severance. Approving this project as it is with no stipulation to save the trees directly violates the city's stated policies. Two, the trees in this mature legacy forest are irreplaceable. Three, trees filter air, stormwater, and reduce runoff. They produce oxygen, cool the air, and sequester carbon. Their presence increases the value of our real estate. Four, the trees slated for destruction constitute the densest and healthiest part of the forest. Five, these woods have suffered from years of reckless development with the demolition of one small segment after another. Further destruction will degrade them as an ecosystem, depriving our community of the benefits ecosystems provide. Six, this ecosystem is a vital asset to our city and should under no circumstance be destroyed or degraded. Thank you for defending this unique asset to our environment. Cynthia Larson. I am writing regarding the proposed additional parking lot at Severance for the MetroHealth expansion. I am opposed to this because we already have too much underutilized parking at Severance. Creating a crosswalk and stoplight for visitors seems like a much better solution. One of the things I value most about Cleveland Heights is the green space and the fact that children can still find wild spaces to explore. This is a rare and valuable thing. Wild green spaces are also good for our air quality and our mental health. It seems like a contradiction to remove more green spaces, more trees for mental health, behavioral health, parking lots. I think our city can come up with a more creative solution. Thank you. Steve Gubkin. I urge you to reject MetroHealth's proposal to remove mature forests along the east and north borders of their property for the purpose of increased parking space. Across Severance Circle are 70 plus acres of mostly unused parking. MetroHealth could lease spaces from the mall owner and a crosswalk and traffic light would be added for safety of employees and patients crossing the road. Replacing a natural forested area with more impervious surfaces would be a grave error when so much underutilized parking space is available in the immediate vicinity. Josephine Moore, regarding the MetroHealth expansion plans. In our city's master plan, we made a commitment to sustainability. We made this commitment because we recognize that the way we do things is not sustainable. For too long, we've exploited and destroyed our natural resources and built in a way that works against our surrounding habitat rather than with it. In doing so, we have been borrowing against our future, and the climate crisis that we are now experiencing is just one of the many indicators that the bill is now coming due. I am asking that you do not approve the aspect of the proposal that will remove a 40-foot strip of mature trees and wetlands they inhabit. This is not just about environmental sustainability. It is also about economic sustainability. These are wetlands. One thing great that wetlands do is absorb stormwater. And the more stormwater that gets absorbed this way, the less that goes into our sewer system, which is already not compliant with EPA guidelines and not sufficient for our storm runoff needs. We know that upgrading our sewer system to meet EPA guidelines and our storm runoff needs is going to be expensive and is a cost that will be passed on to our already overtaxed taxpayers. We also know that the more green space we have, the less storm runoff there is, and thus the less we will need to upgrade our sewer system in the coming years. When we take this into account, it is more economically sustainable to preserve as much green space as we can so we can work with our surrounding habitat rather than against it and therefore minimize cost in the future. We made a commitment to sustainability, and that requires us to change our ways. We need to change how we view our natural environment, how we plan new projects, what we require from people planning to develop, and how we build. We can't keep doing things the same way and expect a different result. This may require creative thinking and new ideas. Luckily, there are smart, resourceful, and innovative people working on this project. I have every confidence that they can find a way to meet the goals of MetroHealth without making our local government turn its back on our city's values and commitments. And with that, I'll turn it back over to Mary.
This is from Pat Dillard. Dear council members, I am totally in favor of MetroHealth's plan to build a facility which will serve adolescents, adults, and seniors suffering from drug and alcohol addiction and behavioral health issues. These services are very much needed in our community. However, I would like to urge the council to be creative in considering the parking situation. Cutting down almost an acre of trees is not in the best interest of anyone. Our tree canopy has been shrinking for many years, and we need to increase it, not cut it down. I do not pretend to have all the answers, but I would suggest one possibility is an attached multi-story parking garage, which would take up less land space and provide easier access to the building for both patients, families, and workers. I have confidence that our council, along with our city planners, can come up with a better solution, one which mirrors our community values. Jan Jones. My name is Jan Hollinger Jones. I have lived in Cleveland Heights for 45 years and worked at MetroHealth for 18. So you might say I have an interest in the proposed expansion of MetroHealth campus at Severance. I am very much in favor of the proposed inpatient mental health facility. However, I am totally opposed to the destruction of much of the adjacent forest to provide 80 parking spaces. I'm opposed because it will upset the ecosystem, which is such an asset to Cleveland Heights. Cleveland Heights supposedly has a policy of sustainability. How can destroying part of our mature forest to build a parking lot make sense when there is a huge unused parking lot across the street? I beg that you reconsider this part of the proposal and try to negotiate with the owners of the old Walmart parking lot. Please save the forest. Thank you. Susan Weber. As concerned citizens of Cleveland Heights, I urge you to require MetroHealth and city staff to explore together how the hospital can utilize parking inside Severance Circle. I believe it is a civic duty to preserve the beauty of our community, and I oppose the clear cutting of trees when so much parking nearby goes wasted. Please act to responsibly preserve the natural environment in our city. Louisa Oliver, I write to endorse the proposed compromise on cutting the trees to make room for parking at the new addition to the MetroHealth facility. Building parking spots around the most mature trees will save the oldest ones, provide shade in a much more attractive area than a flat span of concrete. It adds permeability as well. This compromise will go a long way to demonstrate council's seriousness of purpose and responsive to community concerns. Thank you for your serious consideration, Louisa Oliver. Catherine Petri, members of City Council, thank you for rescheduling your consideration of MetroHealth's expansion plan so as to allow for further public comment. While public comment was permitted at the recent Planning Commission and Board of Controls meeting, notices of those meetings and the opportunity for public comment were not widely distributed. As currently planned, this expansion will have a serious negative environmental impact on our city's mature tree canopy and water quality. Cleveland Heights residents deserve the opportunity to voice their concerns about environmental impact to their elected representatives well in advance of council taking final action. I ask that council delay action on MetroHealth expansion plan until MetroHealth and or the county have pursued all other parking options, including leasing or purchasing some portion of the already existing and underutilized parking area at Severance Town Center. I understand that representation of MetroHealth consider leasing parking space to be unwise, and the leaser might cancel or not renew the lease. Have those representatives taken in consideration that the county has eminent domain powers that might permit the taking of the parking space for MetroHealth's use? I also understand that MetroHealth representatives have expressed safety concerns about employees or patients crossing the Severance Circle Road to access MetroHealth facilities. Those safety concerns, which could easily be met with a pedestrian-friendly stoplight, do not justify the destruction of mature forest and potential contamination of groundwater. At the Board of Control meeting, a county representative cited MetroHealth's not requesting tax abatement as a factor justifying the city's speedy approval of the expansion plan. In fact, the MetroHealth property at Severance has been entirely exempt from property taxes since tax year 2013. The prior owner of that property was the second largest taxpayer in the entire school district. Perhaps as an acknowledgement of the financial impact of the privileged tax position, MetroHealth might respond to community concerns and pursue other readily available parking options rather than contributing to further destruction of our tree canopy and groundwater contamination. Oh, excuse me, Walter Thame. I am writing today to object to the approval of MetroHealth to remove trees along the southern edge of the property for the installation of new on-grade parking. The reasons for my objection are as follows. One, there is no need for additional parking. According to the study by Walker Consultants, no additional parking is required for the facility, including for the new behavioral health center. In addition, parking spaces were needed. MetroHealth's Cleveland Heights facility sits on the edge of a massive underutilized parking lot. Two, according to the Walker Consultants study, the current MetroHealth parking lot could be more efficient through reconfiguration, better signage, and striping with better maintenance. Three, more impermeable paving would add to an already existing stormwater runoff problem. Residents of Cuyahoga County are already paying a premium for precipitation runoff on their property. The county is in the midst of massive decades-long public work project to help eliminate this problem. Adding additional hard surfaces when none are needed would be a bad idea. Four, the existing mature trees provide essential services. They act not only as a visual buffer between Severance Center and the adjacent residential neighborhood, but also as a carbon sink. In conclusion, there isn't a need for additional parking at MetroHealth, and there are multiple reasons not to add additional parking at their facility. Robin Coslin, I have questions that I would like answered. One, what attempts have been made to secure parking for this facility with the owner of Severance Mall? Two, has anyone from the city or MetroHealth attempted to secure a long-term lease for the parking lot presently available next to MetroHealth? Three, has anyone investigated securing the parking through eminent domain? Four, are council members concerned about the lack of transparency involved in this process? Five, MetroHealth submitted their plan to the city on March 2nd, 2012. Does council consider this to be an appropriate timeline to secure community input? Six, the issue of walking from parking adjacent to the Metro facility has been raised as a concern as to why the woods need to be cut down. Is walking not a concern at Metro's West Side facility? David Krause, please consider using the abundant parking available at Severance before the city cuts down any more trees in Tree City for additional parking for the new Metro building. Let's use the resources that are already available and find a creative solution to the situation. Drusilla Robertson, it is my hope that the City Council consider other parking situations for the Metro build. Further deforestation of the area in question would be a travesty. Currently, there are ample areas that are already paved and devoid of life. Please consider using one of these areas before adding to our current asphalt jungle. John Hubbard. There are a lot of links in his email. I'll just give you the start of each of them. No parking expansion for MetroHealth. The planned MetroHealth facility will certainly benefit the city, but there's no need for additional parking, especially at the expense of wetlands, green space, and mature trees. The loss of wetland, particularly in a city with an expensive consent decree, suggests no lessons have been learned. In addition to the existing parking, acres of parking within Severance, you might reference any of hundreds of articles discussing how rideshare is changing the need for parking. Here are a few headlines and links. Note the dates. None of this is new thinking. There's one from govtech.com, future of parking in an era of car sharing, how building owners can prepare for a rise of automation. That's on a website, builtworlds.com. How Uber, self-driving cars, and more are changing real estate. That's on inquire.com. Parking lots disappearing in ride-sharing area as downtown construction booms. Chicago Tribune. Additionally, many articles, including the Wall Street Journal, have reported on the declining number of teens pursuing a driver's license. WallStreetJournal.com. The following Medium article is both more current and more thorough in research cited, reaching the same conclusion. There are fewer drivers, and that's on Medium.com. Essentially, there is absolutely no need for additional parking. Destroying wetlands and trees for unneeded space is irresponsible when forecasts for climate change warn us against such actions. I urge you to reject this plan and focus on future-facing solutions. Robert Berger, I cross Euclid Avenue to get to the Cleveland Clinic. I walk a further distance and cross a much busier street to get there than it would be to cross the road at Severance. On Carnegie, a much busier street, the clinic built a bridge, which is also an alternative for MetroHealth. How does the cost to build the proposed parking lot compare to purchasing parking from Severance? Joan Taslitz, I am against removing any trees to extend the Metro parking lot. Not only do they serve as a natural buffer between the commercial and residential spaces, they also help to keep it cooler, reduce noise, provide oxygen. I live near there and now know that this part of the city is already hotter than other areas. Summer Watterson, I want to write to note my concern regarding the proposed expansion of the MetroHealth facility at the Severance property. Losing more trees in our community is a concern for public health, and I would expect MetroHealth would consider that in their decisions. However, it seems as though there is a plan to move forward with some clear cutting of the Milliken Woods. With the immense amount of parking available at Severance and no obvious intentions to use that space, I'm concerned about the lack of creativity with Cleveland Heights and MetroHealth. Please consider leaving the green space and native woods behind the Milliken building and show the residents of the north side of town that you value their opinion as much as the south side of town. I would also like to note that I am very pleased that MetroHealth is choosing Cleveland Heights for the new behavioral health facility. I just very strongly believe that there are enough creative people on the expansion team to make this work without disrupting the neighborhood. Mary Beth Catt. Cleveland Heights used to be called the City of Trees. Currently, we are creating more and more impermeable surfaces, in this case, right next to a huge impermeable surface, Severance Mall, which has been mostly standing empty for years. I believe that efforts to preserve trees and green space are integral to preserving the beauty of our city, and we all know how impermeable surfaces and continually more serious weather events don't play well together. Susan Myers, I am very opposed to taking our green space away. It has been in our backyard for at least 70 years when it was part of the Severance estate. You have a whole empty mall across the street waiting to become a vital part of Cleveland Heights. Rebuild that area, utilize the vast amount of space that is available to the city, leave the small amount of green space we have in this neighborhood, animals will have nowhere to go but in our yards and do more damage. Photosynthesis uses the energy from the sun's rays to split carbon dioxide from the atmosphere and release more oxygen back to the neighborhood. Sarah Horder, tearing down a forest to be replaced by concrete is regressive and short-sighted. Preservation and sustainability of wild areas, forests, is needed now more than ever, especially considering there is a giant parking lot adjacent to this unused imagination, progressive thinking, I'm sorry, lot adjacent that is unused. Imagination, progressive thinking is essential. Save the trees and existing ecosystem. When the last tree is cut down, the last fish eaten, and the last stream poisoned, you will realize that you cannot eat money. That is a Native American proverb.
Sam Bell, while I strongly support the idea of MetroHealth adding additional service capabilities and capacities to its Severance location, I am concerned about possible detrimental effects of the current project as proposed. Each of you has received a more detailed email from me on this subject already. As the volume of comments you will receive should make clear, it is time to reset the inordinately rushed process surrounding this project. Under normal circumstances, the county, in its MetroHealth guise, would have held one or more community meetings and perhaps a design threat before submitting a project plan. This would have allowed an opportunity for communication and discussion before locking in the final design. The architect of the current plan says it is too late to make any changes. I respectfully disagree. Tree canopy preservation and restoration are key parts of the Cleveland Heights master plan. Like many of my neighbors, I spent many hours and a great deal of effort to make sure that this specific language was included in the master plan. It was not our intention that the city should then ignore this issue. We expect you to hold yourselves accountable to the principles and strategies expressed in the master plan. Accordingly, I call on you to find a way to pause this process while you invite the county to meet with the community. Collectively, we are a group of deeply concerned individuals with a broad range of expertise and a bent for creativity. I am confident that we can find alternative designs that meet both MetroHealth's needs and our own. These are one of the most important weapons in the arsenal against climate change. We've lost a great deal of our urban tree canopy in the past few decades. Let's not lose any more of it for the sake of mere convenience.
I have a request. Jim, I think you could be clearer if you could speak closer to the mic, because I can understand you, but it's not as clear as it could be. That's my opinion.
Can everyone else hear me okay?
I can hear you, but you're not as clear as you could be, I think.
Okay. Well, Danielle Van Heckeren, removing beautiful mature trees at a location that already has ample parking is ridiculous. While we welcome MetroHealth's investment in the well-being of Cleveland Heights residents, we respectfully ask that you utilize the existing infrastructure. There's more than ample parking available in Severn Circle. Until the existing mall is completely inhabited, there is absolutely no reason to pave another square inch of green space. Robert Sanders, please, it's not too late to stop this unnecessary destruction of a precious natural ecosystem. I think that the logical alternative would be using some of the existing parking for their expansion. Access to additional parking is right across the street, or they could build a parking garage. It's time to stop thinking that progress has a God-given right over nature. Thank you. This next comment is Laura Marks. Hello, my good council people. It will greatly benefit Cleveland Heights to have a rehab center at Severance. However, the plan needs to be modified to preserve the stands of trees to the east and north of the proposed building site. Ameliorating Severance was a top priority of the charter review process. Further degradation of the natural features at Severance is counter to this mandate. I have addressed council for years on the benefits of trees. The MetroHealth project is an instance where your understanding of these benefits needs to be taken into consideration in the building design. The buffer zones of the trees need to be left intact. especially the area on the eastern edge of the MetroHealth property that buffers Millikan School from activities on the MetroHealth campus. Let me remind you of some of the benefits of trees. In this case, the standard tree separates land uses. If Millikan were to once again be a viable elementary school, I would want the children to be separated from drug addicts. Trees cool the urban heat island. Severance has 50 acres of impermeable surface absorbing heat. Trees absorb water. The area to the east of the parking lot is a vernal pool wetland. Homes downhill from Severance, including my house, have wet basements because the former wetlands at Severance have been replaced by impermeable surfaces. Trees reduce all stress-related diseases, including heart attack, stroke, COPD, and addiction. Trees reduce respiratory diseases such as asthma and bronchitis. Trees reduce crime, including domestic violence. Trees reduce depression and anxiety. Trees increase property values. Trees cause people to spend more time and more money in shopping districts where they are present. Trees give shade that encourages people to gather, strengthening communities. The tree canopy in the neighborhood south of Severance is one of the most depleted in the city of Cleveland Heights. Please do not allow it to be degraded further. Cleveland Heights, as in most cities, has a disparity of the benefits of trees. The negative impacts would disproportionately affect the residents of the northeastern portion of Cleveland Heights. We grieved when Coventry Fairmount area lost 56 trees in the microburst of 2019. At Severance, we are looking at losing even more trees by our own hand, not an act of God. Trees clean our air and water. Trees give food and habitat to birds and other species. Reiterating, I hope to see a rehab center built at MetroHealth. We simply need to design the facility to accommodate both humans and other species. People are happier and healthier when we live with trees. Thank you for your service to the community. This comment is Mark Sauling. While I support the proposal for MetroHealth to add a behavioral health facility to its Cleveland Heights campus, I am very concerned that the proposed footprint expansion plan being considered by council unnecessarily destroys valued woodland and environmentally sensitive land. I live in the neighborhood directly affected by the expansion, and a lot of my neighbors put great value on the legacy wooded area to the east of the current MetroHealth facility. The city's statement on valuing sustainability says, sustainability creates and maintains the conditions under which humans and nature can exist in productive harmony, yet permit fulfilling the social, economic, and ecological requirements of present and future generations. The proposed expansion would cast that principle aside. Furthermore, a rushed decision with little opportunity for citizen and neighborhood input would violate trust in the city's government. I am asking council to require the developer to go back to the drawing board and present a design that honors the city's and our neighborhood's values. Next comment is Isabel Troutline. Save Millikan Forest, a community treasure. An old forest with its intricate balances is a community treasure, providing a space to restore our senses from urban life. Habitat for animals, cleans our air and water, and restores and is irreplaceable once destroyed. It is especially tragic that it would be destroyed to create parking across from our city's largest unused parking lots. It's Severance Mall, and ironic that it would be done to ease parking for people with mental health issues in a world where the loss of natural surroundings and healthy ecosystems take a measurable toll on our collective mental health. Please save our forest. Now, this comment is Emma Shook. I'm writing as a 20-year resident of the Heights. I and my partner, Aaron Shiloh, are part of several volunteer and environmental restoration groups in the Heights. Friends of Lower Lake, Friends of the Walt, Friends of the Bradford, Cinder Path, and have learned much about the state of our natural areas. We're working hard every weekend to restore health to our dwindling natural areas. But the hugest positive impact on our natural areas is preservation from development in the first place. In the midst of an extinction crisis, there is currently and has been a big push in Ohio to develop. Since I moved here in 2001, I have witnessed thousands of acres of habitats destroyed to create Legacy Village, Pinecrest, the seemingly endless expansion of Cleveland Clinic and university hospitals and luxury residences. And now the expansion of MetroHealth. Meanwhile, we have more than enough unused vacant acreage to rebuild upon. Every tree cut, every wetland destroyed, every inch of topsoil removed, it takes thousands of years for several inches of topsoil to be created. All of this is not only contributing to the climate crisis by releasing carbon, but the already splintered web of life here is being systematically destroyed. This is not a knee-jerk reaction. This is a thoughtful, science-based, morality-based response. We need to stop prioritizing long-term environmental destruction for short-term profit and start prioritizing the existence of pollinators, native birds, and amphibians, reptiles, and mammals. It is for our own health that we honor the health of our natural communities. There are many unused acres in Sovereign Circle. There simply must be an alternative, whether repurposing the old Walmart or its vast unused parking lot. Suzanne Miller, please find a way to accommodate MetroHealth's need for additional parking space without sacrificing the almost acre of mature trees close to the buildings. A huge portion of the Sovereign Center parking lot across the road from Metro is now being used mainly by seagulls. It's a logical choice for Metro parking. Bottom line, health and trees are natural partners. Constance Whalen, this project is an incredible thing for our city. While I understand that some residents are concerned about the small section of trees being removed, it's an extremely small price to pay for the human lives that will be improved as a result of this facility going up. A comprehensive sustainability plan is about much more than the trees, and to hold this project up or risk wasting more time is the wrong thing to do for Cleveland Heights. Severance Town Center is the area in town that needs the most attention, and this project will serve as a potential gateway for a complete redevelopment effort, a new vision for the area. Thank you, MetroHealth, for this incredible opportunity for our city. This comment is from Myron Kaufman. At a time when forestation is considered an important tool to slow climate change, deforestation to create parking spaces is just wrong. This comment is from Paul Epstein. I support the construction of the Behavioral Health Center. However, because of what appears to be the architecturally lazy decision to cut down some of the last remaining vestiges of Cleveland Heights old growth forest for parking spaces, when a sea of available parking is a few hundred feet away, I urge council to vote no. Send the plans back to make what should be some fairly easy adjustments and resubmit them for approval. That shouldn't take too long. Effectively planning a city requires care and a deep acknowledgement of all its underlying environmental systems, social, structural, and ecological. Ideally, it should be shaped by the community itself, not by developers or the politicians who court their dollars. It is, by its nature and necessity, a slow process, hardly something to be decided upon in an emergency session. The plans have sat on the shelf since last December. Now suddenly it has to be wrapped up in 3 weeks. All this haste might lead one to think, what real motives are they hiding? In truth, to be rushing major development at this very moment, when city government is about to undergo a sea change, and the extent of our sewer problems is yet unknown, smells a bit irresponsible. This whole affair underscores the massive dysfunction in our city government and why that sea change is so welcome. Thank you. Sladonna Kirstick, I'm contacting you in respect to the proposal to rim Forest Edge for Cleveland Heights MetroHealth expansion. I believe that we should plant trees, not cut them. It is great that MetroHealth wants to expand, but if they want extra parking lot space, they can do underground parking. This comment is from Grant Market. While I support increased access to mental health services in our city with the proposed MetroHealth expansion at Severance, removing trees and encroaching on what little wetland we have referring to the Milliken Wood, doesn't make sense, especially since there's plenty of parking and land all around the rest of the circle. I understand new trees will be planted, but I am voicing concern about the hydrological issues this expansion presents. Our city needs to consider the health of our environment and particularly our watershed first. Sue Hannibal, please save this vital resource. There are viable solutions to the parking situation, but it requires determination and ingenuity. Who has the courage to do so? Who has the courage to do the right thing? And with that, I turn it over to you, Susanna.
Steve Kagan. Dear council members, in the world we live in today, where the critical problems of global climate change, loss of habitat, and loss of biodiversity are finally being recognized for the important issues they are, there are some things that individual cities and towns, even neighborhoods and street organizations, can do. One of those things that can be managed locally is increasing the tree canopy cover in our neighborhoods. This is not a small thing. There is plenty of research that demonstrates the important positive effect of tree cover and the negative effect of losing trees, affects not only environmental, but social and even public health. Sadly, municipalities in Cuyahoga County that have not been bad in this respect are getting there, becoming worse. In this context, the issue of how the MetroHealth facility is going to expand takes on extreme importance. We are MetroHealth patients and long-term residents of Cleveland Heights. We know City Council faces an important decision. In essence, you are going to tell us whether you think the issues connected to environmental defense and the quality of life in our city are important enough to act on, even if it means confronting an institution as strong as MetroHealth. We hope with all our hearts that you will see the importance of conserving the little bit of old forest that remains. When we moved here 50 years ago, there was much forest all through the periphery of Severance. And our understanding was that conserving it was one of the terms of the transfer to the city. Over these decades, we have seen most of it lost. It is time to stop. Please do the right thing. Catherine Pankhurst. This is a critical moment when the Tree City must act to protect old growth forest and the precious dwindling green space in its boundaries. It's unthinkable that MetroHealth wants to tear down a wooded lot for parking when there is a vast wasteland of disused, underused parking across the street. Now is the time to realize that the underutilized parking is a way to recover from pandemic retail loss while giving the community much needed medical service. Severance may never be the retail hub it once was. Don't waste this opportunity to redeem the use of space. Aside from the parking lot, this area has been served well by public transportation. It will benefit employees and patients. Christopher Wood, to the council and residents. When I first heard about the building of a new behavior health hospital at the Metro facility, I thought it was a great idea, both for those who might need its service and for our city. I envisioned it being built in the parking lot to the east of the current building. How naive, the plan to cut old trees in a small but intact forested area is ludicrous, given that Severance is a vast wasteland. Can it truly be impossible to make use of some of that parking? The city should make the planners work a little harder. Kevin Schneer, the Cleveland Heights community is known for and loves its trees. Greenery increases the value of properties, aids in erosion, and cleans our air. In the last few years, the percentage of tree covering has decreased from 37% to 35% in Cuyahoga County. In Cleveland Heights, we have lost 11% of our tree canopy. Natural causes for loss include aging, disease, and insects. Unnecessary clear cutting, such as the proposal for the Milliken Woods, is one of the top human causes for tree destruction. The symbol for Cleveland Heights is a tree sprouting. Let's support plans that support our logo. James Levin, Please save the trees. One of the great assets of this city is the old growth trees, majestic and irreplaceable. I realize that the hospital could be an anchor tenant at Severance and needs to be accommodated, but cutting out trees ought to be an absolute last resort. In fact, I look forward to the day where anyone cutting down a tree whose diameter is more than 14 inches needs a permit. The trees are not just owned by a property owner. They provide beauty, shade, rest, and oxygen for everyone. God knows we do not need any more asphalt. Allowing these kinds of trees to be cut will quickly transform Cleveland Heights into South Euclid. Christine Borkin. This is about the MetroHealth expansion. Please help Metro find alternative space inside the circle rather than cutting down 200-year-old trees. Once they are gone, we can't get them back. We don't want our only trees to be the one on the city logo. There are so few underdeveloped places in the city. It is also our job to be good stewards of the land, including the wildlife. Barbara Wehrle, please consider utilizing the parking spaces inside Severance Circle instead of killing trees to make more spaces. Perhaps you could redirect the ring road inward so that people won't have to cross a road to get to the hospital. Thank you for considering this option. Mary Simpson, I oppose the encroachment on Milliken Woods at Severance by the MetroHealth project. I am at the point where I am opposed to anything that takes green away from Cleveland Heights. There are too many proposals right now, all destroying green space. Our housing is increasing in value, which is good. This is because people like Cleveland Heights, and that is because of its character. These proposals will destroy its character. It is time to hold the line on taking down trees and taking away more green space. I join with citizens that want to have our council rethink this before taking away green space, not after. That would mean halting this now. Lisa Rainsong. I just learned of the proposed MetroHealth expansion impact on mature trees in the Milliken Woods. A plan that necessitates cutting down these trees for 80 new parking spaces. This isn't acceptable. Metro needs to do better. Of course, it would be great to have Metro expand here, but this is not the way to proceed. We already have significant tree loss in Tree City, and eliminating more trees to add more concrete and asphalt to the Severance area cannot be part of this plan. We're supposed to be protecting and expanding our tree canopy and working to mitigate the effects of climate change, aren't we? I'm sure many Cleveland Heights residents have already written about the value of these trees for birds, native insects, and wildlife, and for the human residents in the area as well. I've been a homeowner here for 26 years and a renter for longer. I urge you to require a more environmentally responsible plan. Anne Caruso. Council members, I am very disappointed in council's inability to understand that 27 acres of old growth forest are not insignificant, especially when there are obvious alternatives which should have been explored first, not last. Alternatives such as asking if some of the existing parking can be rented by Metro, or gauging whether a parking garage can be constructed on land that is not part of this old growth forest. We are in a severe climate crisis. Did you know that? I ask this because your lack of awareness about the preciousness of 27 acres of old growth forest tells me you don't understand what is at stake and what must be done to avert the end of life as we know it. Trees are the perfect defense against irreversible, catastrophic climate change. Trees are so important and necessary that volunteers in Cleveland Heights are vigorously planting trees wherever they can. This is because a trillion more trees are needed on planet Earth. According to the Arbor Day Foundation, in 1 year, a mature tree will absorb more than 48 pounds of carbon dioxide from the atmosphere and release oxygen in exchange. It is proposed that one large tree can provide a day's supply of oxygen for up to 4 people. One council member recently said that the public had ample time to weigh in. I can't find anyone who is aware of the specifics of this project. If it hadn't been for 2 citizens who alerted many of us, there would have been no public impact at all before your vote. Please reconsider this plan and prioritize the old growth forest we are blessed to have. And there's 2 websites, OregonMetro.gov and USDA.gov. Alana Baldwin, excuse me, my light went off. Alana Baldwin, as a Cleveland Heights resident, I am appalled by the current proposal to gut down the woods in the Severance area to expand parking for Metro. While I fully support the facility, there is already extensive parking in that area. While it may take additional work to make use of the space, it would be well worth it. Please do not create waste and asphalt in a natural space when there is already so much space to be used. We can and should do better. Clifford Burns, regarding MetroHealth Severance, explore using the Severance parking lot and not destroying trees that have been growing there for years. Planting some shrubs, bushes, and trees after the destruction is not sufficient. I'm a resident of this neighborhood since 1995. The area is haunted by empty parking lots and empty commercial structures. No need to destroy more woods. Jeremy Baldwin, there is a ridiculous amount of excess parking in the Severance area. Cutting down trees to make more so that one building can say that it has enough parking that belongs to it would be like knocking down a playground to add more grass to a soccer field, just in case your entire family reunion wanted to watch a game someday. You're destroying something that benefits the community in one way to make more of something that we already have enough of, just so you can say that you control enough of it. If we looked at the parking as a public resource and not a private one, then Metro would not need to be concerned that it did not have adequate parking. Clearly, there is plenty, a huge portion of which goes unused on a daily basis. Instead of building more parking, we should better allocate the use of the parking we already have by using the power of City Council to ensure that parking near Home Depot and the old Walmart is not exclusively the property of those organizations, but can be used without penalty by any visitor. Would some visitors to Metro have to walk a bit? Yes, but it would be trivial for them to set aside reserved parking for the mobility impaired, and as health professionals, they surely can understand the benefits of walking a little more. It is not reasonable for them to ask to cut down local trees to make more parking, any more than it would be for them to ask us to use local water to fill up Lake Erie.
Tiffany Mosley. Severance is full of open space and closed storefronts. If people can walk half a mile or more across busy streets to get to the Cleveland Clinic, they can walk across Severance to get to Metro. Cutting down mature trees when there is an abundance of open space available is destructive and will make Metro look like an open eyesore instead of the inviting hospital you might plan on building. There are many questions that should be answered before you destroy an ecosystem as old as the one around Severance. Do you have to make your own space? What is stopping you from using or changing the open space available? What is the best way to keep the current forestry the way it is? How will patients and staff handle the wildlife returning looking for their homes? Sandy Stone. Dear Council, you've heard our neighbors' environmental concerns regarding further destruction of the Severance Millican Woods. Please listen and move towards other alternatives. This is spring, and so much pending and new life will be killed in these woods if these woods are torn down. Please consider our pleas. Please. Bob Rink. I support the Planning Commission's recommendation approving the MetroHealth's proposed expansion, including the currently negotiated parking variance. I find it disingenuous that many in the opposition who oppose the sacrificing of a few trees are also part of the same group who consistently whine about the lack of development at Severance. Here is a positive opportunity to have a stable, positive, job-creating development by a very responsible nonprofit, and they want to reject it over the preservation of a few trees, which can be replaced elsewhere. Excuse me, people, why you can't have it both ways. How many jobs and positive development have the trees created in all these years they've been there? And it's not like they cannot and will not be replaced. Using the across-the-road parking, in my opinion, would be a dangerous alternative, even if the legal issues to secure it its use could be worked out. As with Top of the Hill, every project in the city seems to be able to find or create its opponents who see opposition to each and every development project as their birthright. I respectfully would ask City Council to approve the project as presented so the city can get on with the real work it is encouraging. Mary Kelsey. Scientists now understand that trees in a forest are interdependent such that the loss of individuals impacts the health of the whole. Losing 3/4 of an acre of trees doesn't seem like much until you consider that constitutes 3% of the whole forest. It's a stable climax forest stand that cannot be replaced or compensated by planting new trees elsewhere. Healthy natural areas are important to quality of life in Cleveland Heights as a place where families and professionals want to live. A different parking site plan must be developed that doesn't carve into the woods. Debbie Applepresser. Cleveland Heights prides itself for the beautiful trees and gardens we plant, nurture, and love. He, she who plants a tree, plants a hope, Lucy Larson. Isn't this what health care is all about? It has been proven that nature heals. Isn't healing the point here? Between every two trees, there is a door leading to a new way of life, John Muir. The best time to plant a tree was 20 years ago. The second best time is now, Chinese proverb. We are talking about health care here. Are we so lazy that we have to cut down mature trees so we can walk less steps? What is the message here? Severance is already a sea of parking spaces. The whole thought is so sad, and the boy loved the tree very much, and the tree was happy. Shel Silverstein. Harriet Applegate. Before you vote to approve MetroHealth's plans, please consider the following. 1. A simple, easy solution presents itself. The trees could be saved if 79 parking spaces are removed from MetroHealth's property to 7th Circle directly across the street from MetroHealth's entrance. 2. City Council is uniquely positioned to make this proposal. It is MetroHealth's job to consider what is cheapest, easiest, quickest, and most efficient for them. Only you are entrusted with doing what is best for the citizens of Cleveland Heights. 3. Naturally, MetroHealth would not consider building on land that it doesn't own, so it is up to you to come up with the alternatives that accommodate all parties. For you, the ultimate party is your constituents. 4. The blight that is Severance Circle is not of concern to MetroHealth, but it is your concern. 5. From the standpoint of Cleveland Heights residents, the optics of City Council allowing the destruction of even one tree, much less hundreds of them, when acres of empty parking lot exist as close to MetroHealth as the forest they want to cut is surreal, painful, and ironic. 6. Only you have the ability to negotiate with NAMDAR to make an accommodation for use of unused parking space. Bonus. The ocean of empty parking lot is put to good use, and the waste that Severance Circle has become would have some utility once again. 7. Others have spoken, written, and called with eloquent and elegant descriptions of the desirability and scientific necessity of preserving these trees. They have schooled you on the difference between an ecosystem which provides untold benefits for health, quality of life, and the connection between community building and stewardship of natural resources on the one hand, and landscaping. Green space is in no way comparable to the complicated and wondrous ecosystem that a forest provides. 8. As cities all across the country are working hard to increase their tree canopy, it is not a good look for Cleveland Heights to be facilitating the destruction of tree canopy. Other cities would kill to have the valuable assets of an urban forest a few hundred yards away from City Hall. You, on the other hand, have shown absolutely no interest in or respect for this wonderful asset on your front door. Indeed, in their short-sighted zeal for the thoughtless and ultimately ruinous economic development that has resulted in the current blight at Severance Circle, your predecessors did everything in their power to reduce and all but destroy it. It is time to pay the piper. Do your job. Represent the needs of citizens, do what's best for the city. Explain to MetroHealth that your duty is to citizens and that you want to proceed as quickly as possible to work out a deal whereby you will facilitate parking across the ring road for them so that they can save the trees. Anything less renders you derelict in your responsibility to represent your constituents and do what is best for the city. Mark Chupp. As a patient of the MetroHealth systems that uses the Severance Center facility, I'm excited to see that Metro has chosen to expand at this site. Severance is largely abandoned, so having new development and increased use of this part of the city is excellent. However, the destruction of older forests in the midst of acres of unused parking lot is unconscionable. I am deeply concerned by what appears to be city council and the city's willingness to lose a significant asset that cannot be replaced for generations, conceding to the demands of a large institution rather than to your voters and taxpayers. This is our community, one heralded for its natural environment and tree-lined streets. Severance is the one exception to this profile, and this plan further scars our community with more buildings and parking lot void of mature tree. I am disappointed that Metro's response, which reminds me of the developers of Legacy Village, who committed to keep the buffer trees and to plant more trees. In the end, they cut all growth out along Cedar Road that was 25 feet from the ground. Instead, they landscaped it with mulching ornamental trees. They replaced a natural area with sticks of trees to allow people to see the new shopping buildings. They kept their commitment. The lessons for me are to preserve the asset as it is, get everything in writing, and be insistent on what our community needs. MetroHealth will not walk away from this deal. If we begin with the premise that the forest will not be reduced, then creative options can be found. Start with what our community believes is a non-negotiable. Do not remove mature forests when vacant land surrounds the other side of the site. Jonathan Epstein and Martin Gowrie, to the City of Cleveland Heights council members. As 22-year-long residents of Cleveland Heights, my husband and I are proud of the forward-looking agenda our city often embraces. The MetroHealth facility proposal stands as no exception. The addition of this care facility would be a marked game changer for what has been an increasingly underserved population. For the last 8 years, I have worked as a dedicated volunteer for the National Alliance on Mental Illness of Greater Cleveland, or NAMIGC. As a frontline peer support specialist and voice for the unheard, I work with patients, train police cadets and police forces in crisis intervention training, and speak to medical, academic, and various community organizations. In such capacities, I continue to witness firsthand the harsh realization and the needs of our community when it comes to mental illness, where between 1 in 4 and 1 in 5 people are afflicted and 60% of whom go untreated. The facilities I currently work with include Highland Springs, MetroHealth Lutheran Hospital, part of the Cleveland Clinic Foundation, and the LGBT Center of Greater Cleveland. To the best of my knowledge, none of these has experienced any uptick in crime or disturbances in their respective neighborhoods because of the concentration of behavioral health services provided. In fact, the outreach to each of their respective surrounding communities has increased the awareness and accessibility to the desired necessary care. What we require are additional facilities geared toward the provision of tailored care for behavioral health without any stigma attached. As a result, I wholeheartedly and without reservation support the passage of MetroHealth's proposal to build upon its current commitment to our city. The proposed layouts of the building and of adjacent areas appear sound. Projected staffing levels seem adequate. The hospital system has gone above and beyond to listen to residents and partner with the city to address their concerns and modify the proposal accordingly. No plan is perfect. That should go without saying. However, MetroHealth has modified its proposal with sincerity to the interests of residents. As a reminder, MetroHealth is not a for-profit institution. It belongs to all of us Cuyahoga County residents. It is their purpose to serve the healthcare needs, which includes behavioral, of our communities. Please ask yourselves where you would turn if you, a spouse, a child, or a grandchild required behavioral health services when you felt no one would listen or cared or there were no beds available anywhere. These are real concerns, not hyperbole. Clearly, the passage of this proposal this evening has attached with it low risk but high reward. I respectfully request you consider my and my husband's viewpoint in your council's decision making.
I'm sorry to interrupt, but it's been almost 2 hours of public comment, and I must end the reading of public comments early because one of our council colleagues has a flight to catch tonight and was already gracious enough in rebooking that flight later tonight so that they could be here tonight for this important meeting. So we do need to move on, though. So I apologize if you didn't have your comment read. But I do ask the city manager to the remaining comments, which I think we are down to almost single digits, maybe. Please put them in an email and have it distributed to council so that we can see and read those communications.
I can definitely do that, Your Honor.
Thank you. So we're going to move on now to MetroHealth is going to make a short presentation.
Great. All right. Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Thank you, Council. And Ms. Himmelin, if you could give Adam May the ability to put up the slide, if you could give him control for that, I'd appreciate it. I'm Joe Froelich, MetroHealth Senior Vice President, and as of this June, a 40-year resident of Cleveland Heights. It's good to be with you again. 4 months and 1 day since Dr. Bruner and I were there to unveil MetroHealth's plans to add a behavioral health and addiction services expansion to our medical center and hospital at 10 Severance Circle. Since then, we've worked with the city and members of the community to refine the plan before you tonight. We've tried to listen well and adapt, and that will continue. At the request of city staff, we've been asked to review a few key aspects of the proposal, so let me start with economic impact. We're already a major stakeholder at Severance, and we will invest another $42 million there, and we're asking no incentives from the city to do so. Right now, we have nearly 200 employees at our MetroHealth Cleveland Heights Medical Center with an annual payroll of about $15 million. In the first year that our behavioral health addition is open, we expect to add 155 full-time employees and close to another $10 million in payroll. By year five, we'll have 225 employees on the behavioral health side of the house alone. The additional income taxes to Cleveland Heights by then will be roughly $350,000 a year. Now let me move on to the environmental questions that were the number one concern we've heard tonight. Adam, if you could put up the slide, that would be great, of the overview of the site's plan. MetroHealth owns about 6 3/4 acres of wooded land, most to the east of our current campus. To enable this expansion, to build the new hospital wing in a corridor that can accommodate ambulances or fire vehicles trying to reach our emergency department, we need to clear a little less than 3/4 acre. We calculate that nearly 98% of the Severance Woods, or the Milliken Woods as some folks say, and almost 90% of the forest on our property will remain intact. There will still be, as you'll note here, 660 feet of wooded area between our campus and the nearest homes to the east. Now, if we could do this project without taking down a single tree, we would. We can't, in part because we're blocked from expanding on three sides. So let me explain what we did do and will do. When our design team realized that to meet current parking requirements, we would have to take down a far larger piece of the forest, we spent $10,000 on an independent parking study that convinced us, as well as the planning department and the planning commission, that we can operate the expanded campus with nearly 300 fewer parking spaces. That will preserve another 90,000 feet of woodlands, about three times of what we think we need to remove. And understand that most of the wooded area is being taken for the ambulance route I mentioned. Right now, ambulances reach our ED by driving through a parking lot used by visitors and employees. This new perimeter route will allow ambulances and fire engines to bypass the construction zone in the short run, and when the new wing is built, to easily reach the emergency department. It will be safer for everyone. As for the land that will be cleared, we will replace all trees as required by the city's preservation code. We think the number will be between 50 and 60, but whatever it is, that's what we'll plant and maintain. After discussions with local environmentalists and our own sustainability officer, we promise to plant only native species throughout the campus, and we will add pollinator gardens. We will maintain all trees on our property in accord with the best practices of urban forestry. Our plans include 2 underground retention systems that will control the volume of stormwater released into the city sewers. The system was designed in accord with city regulations and has been approved by the Northeast Ohio Regional Sewer District. We're doing all that because the environment is important to our patients and to our community and us, because we're here for the long haul. We're not building big box retail or a chain restaurant that might be empty in a decade. We're building a place where, as our CEO, Dr. Akram Boutros often says, our family members, friends, and neighbors can be treated with compassion. We're building the hospital to care for sick people. Sick people who right now, as Dr. Bruner said back in November, too often can't get the treatment they desperately need. MetroHealth has served the people of Cuyahoga County for 184 years. We're your public hospital, your essential hospital. You can trust us not to cut corners, not on the environment, not on security, not on quality of design or construction, because we're gonna be here for a long, long time. I'm proud as a Heights resident that almost no one at any of our community conversations or tonight has questioned the need for this expansion. And I want to assure my neighbors, and you, Mayor Stein, and your colleagues, that this will be a place of hope that will embody the spirit of Cleveland Heights and make us all proud. Thank you.
Thank you, Joe. Suzanne, I'm not sure, was staff prepared to make a short presentation now, or is that something later?
When you reach the point of sending it to a committee for a vote, the planning director, Eric, will give a presentation of the timeline of the process and then all of the accommodations that are attached. So you can go into your the rest of your agenda right now, to, if you so choose, to go to the committee report of planning and development.
Okay, that sounds good. That's exactly what we're going to do. Let's move on to committee reports. Planning and Development Committee, Councilperson Unger. You're on mute, Mike.
Mute.
So Susanna, I mean, I assume you want me to yield it back to staff to make its report to the council.
Well, you're introducing resolution number 28 and ask for.
Okay, I introduce resolution number 28 and move passage.
Is there a second?
Second.
Thank you.
Okay, and now we'll hear from staff.
Yes, our planning director, Eric Sam.
Thank you.
Okay, good evening, council, members of council, members of the public, and the applicant. I have a short presentation before you continue your discussions. And let me know if you see it all on your screen. There's been a number of meetings and presentations on the project beginning back in November of last year, actually that's 2020, a presentation by MetroHealth to City Council. February 10th was the first submittal of the application by the applicant, which was commented on by staff and revised on February the 23rd. March 2nd was the first Board of Control public hearing where it was referred to the Planning Commission. Also that evening, the Architectural Board of Review had a public hearing and approved the project. MetroHealth had a Zoom meeting with the community on March 4th, another one with the Severn neighbors on the 9th. The Planning Commission held their first public hearing on the 10th of March and then scheduled a special public hearing on the 17th, where they had approval and recommendation to the Board of Control. The Board of Control had a public hearing number 2 on the 18th, where they approved the project. And tonight, of course, is your consideration of approval of that approval. Just to highlight that there has been a number of ways for the public to comment, as you just heard. All the materials have been posted on the website, and there's been a number of different commitments and meetings by the applicant. So now going into the proposed legislation as proposed by the Board of Control to you, Section 1 essentially affirms the analysis, review, and recommendations of the Board of Control and the Planning Commission. Section 2 approves the Board of Control's approval of the amendment to the detailed development plan. Section 3 approves the Board of Control's approval of the variance for a reduction in parking to 402 spaces from 700. And then Section 4 is where we get into the conditional use permit and the conditions. I'll read them very quickly. I'll skip to each of them, and they are lettered. A, all new additional signage shall be require review and approval by the Board of Control prior to the issuance of any building permit and installation of any signage. B, the earthen berm on the southern portion of the site shall be extended eastward and included on the final landscape plan. C, additional bushes and shrubbery shall be planted in the southern 150-foot buffer area to discourage cut-through pedestrian movement and included on the final landscape plan. D, the applicant shall work with the planning department on refining the landscaping and plantings, including species, number, and location, as well as consideration of a pollinator garden. A final landscape plan shall be provided as specified in zoning code section 1166.02 and 1166.03, which will need to be approved by the planning director before the issuance of a building permit or certificate of occupancy. E, details on the tree inventory, tree impacts, and tree preservation during construction shall be provided and shall comply with a final tree preservation plan in accordance with zoning code section 1166.11, which will need to be approved by the zoning administrator prior to the issuance of a building permit. F, the 150-foot deep densely wooded setback area along the east and south border shall continue to be maintained so that the trees visually screen the project from the residentially zoned properties to the east and south. Trees shall be planted periodically by the applicant if necessary to maintain and preserve the wooded setback's present character. An arborist should be retained to guide the long-term tree maintenance strategy. G, the zoning administrator, on the basis of increased parking demand for the use, may require alternative approaches or the conversion of all or part of the land banked area to off-street parking spaces. Such conversion shall require approval by the Board of Control and Planning Commission. H, the applicant should implement the recommendations related to the improvements to parking lots found in the January 29th, 2021 parking study by Walker Consultants. I, ambulance sirens shall continue to not be used upon entering Severance Town Center. The applicant shall reach out to the fire and EMS departments that use the facility to remind them of the no siren zone. J, the facility shall be maintained and operated so that the noise generated from the site does not create a nuisance to the abutting residential properties of Severn Road. K, the self-test of each generator on the site shall take place between the hours of 7 a.m. and 7 p.m., and each shall be conducted no more than once monthly for a maximum of a half hour per day, unless change is approved by the planning director. L, the applicant shall establish a clear channel for neighbors to bring issues to our attention quickly and get a timely response from MetroHealth. And finally, M, the city may require the applicant to return to the Board of Control for additional approvals should the goals and objectives of the conditional use not be met. And committee chair, that is my presentation. Oh, and there are two more sections at the end that are really legal in nature, which I won't read.
Okay, Mike, you're up.
Jason, I'd just like to invite, I know that council member Hart has a friendly amendment that she wants to add, and she will confirm momentarily, and I've independently confirmed with both the applicant and with our staff that it is acceptable to both of them. So I'm certainly willing to accept it and allow my motion to be amended to include that. And I'd like to yield the floor to Councilmember Hart now, so she can tell us what she has in mind. And I don't believe it's controversial.
I would like to add a condition N, so an additional condition that says, while moving forward with the project, the applicant shall actively investigate parking alternatives, such as renting of Severance existing parking area that could preserve the trees adjacent to the buffer zone.
And I accept that amendment. And if we could get a second to the.
I'll second that.
Okay, thank you. So now we have it up. Thank you, Melody. Thank you, Davida.
Okay, so I believe Mrs. Hemline, we need a roll call, please, or vote. I'm sorry.
Hart.
Aye.
Russell.
Aye.
Sarin.
Aye.
Stein.
Aye.
Unger.
Aye.
Dunbar.
Aye.
Six ayes, Your Honor.
We're back to resolution number 28-2021 as amended. Was there any discussion on this? Did anyone want to speak, ask a question, make a statement?
I'm just happy that she added that portion of the resolution to have active discussions trying to maintain the trees. So thank you for that additional language into that resolution.
Mary.
I just like to say that I'm now on my 10th year on City Council, and it's been very wonderful to see the developments that are happening in Cleveland Heights. What's been happening in the world is a big population growth that has impacted forests in places like Africa and Brazil. During the Second World War, the population of the world was between 2 and 3 billion. I see different estimates now, 7 to 9 billion. And you know, you think people can be poor in this country. You haven't seen anything.
if you haven't been to Africa. And so but that's not what's been happening in Cleveland Heights. We've been losing population. And for maybe 2 years ago, we were taking down 50 or a couple of years ago, 50 or 60 houses every year from the foreclosure. So we now are on a trajectory where we're starting to get some growth and rehabs of houses and talking about infill housing and other developments. And I just think that this is critical for our community. I also feel that we, based on what people say, developers, we don't get a lot of applicants rushing to come to the city. We're difficult to work with because we have a lot of requirements. And that's because we love our city just the way it is, a lot of us. But it's, in order to maintain the level of services that we have, we need to embrace projects that make sense for us and that promote some growth in our tax base. And so I'm not going to do anything to stand in the way of this development because I think it's important for the city. And yes, we do have a great opportunity to do better at Severance Center in general, but this is a positive development in my view.
Mr. President.
Khalil.
I just have a brief statement to read. So in Cleveland Heights, city council members aren't expected to be experts on every conceivable subject, and we aren't elected to walk in lockstep on every decision either. The people place us in these roles with our individual experience, perspective, and expertise as representatives collectively making decisions on their behalf. Most of the decisions placed before us are relatively routine and non-controversial. Tonight, we are asked to make a decision that at first may have appeared that way, but through the community's response, we can be certain that we were mistaken. This evening, we've received a lot of input from residents, and we've received some information from the applicant and the administration about the project before us. Under regular order, this council would have time to incorporate the expressed will of the community and the needs of the applicant into a more creative compromise. I want this project to move forward. I believe in this project. I think it could be the beginning of a dynamic re-envisioning of Severance as a whole. However, this process deviates from regular order dramatically and in a way that inhibits a deeper examination by this council in view of the people we represent. On projects where council has an approval role, our normal operation has been that we are provided a detailed explanation of the project, given an opportunity to ask questions, receive more information, and request amendment when necessary. In this case, we have not been afforded that opportunity. If Cleveland Heights residents are to be asked to sacrifice their values to the benefit of this project, we owe it to the people to substantively consider all reasonable options to minimize that sacrifice. Any additional time considering the consequences of the present design may be characterized as an unreasonable delay of this project. But I would remind my colleagues, the administration, and the applicant that these plans were made public approximately 3 weeks ago. This application has moved very swiftly through this public process. We have not imposed unnecessary delay on the applicant. Real due diligence by council as a body and expedited additional negotiation with the applicant in response to this public input does not impose undue delay on the project, especially since we can easily come back to the table with a reasonable compromise that may not be perfect, but will truly minimize the impact on this natural infrastructure that our residents want us to protect to the best of our ability. The parking study from Walker Consulting calculated a future parking demand of 236 stalls. In its report, Walker established an optimal level of surplus parking that would create the most efficient parking scenario for staff, visitors, and patients. The optimal level would increase that 236 stalls by 5 to 15%, creating a cushion of at max 35 stalls that would improve the flow of traffic in the parking area. The city, through the Planning Commission, granted a variance of 402 parking stalls, which the applicant admitted in the March 2nd Board of Control meeting was more parking than they will need. According to their study, the 402 parking stalls described in the applicant's plan allows for over 130 surplus parking stalls, well above the optimal level established in the report. The current variance requested, though well under the excessive 700 parking stalls required by our code, still includes excessive parking. I suggest that we postpone our final decision on this matter to allow for an amended application that would seek a variance that more closely reflects MetroHealth's actual parking needs according to the parking study they commissioned. MetroHealth would still enjoy the optimal surplus described in the Walker Consulting study, and a not insignificant number of trees would be spared. A simple variance can be easily and swiftly granted and would free MetroHealth to eliminate all 86 of the land bank parking stalls in the current plan, as well as the 44 planned parking stalls on the north and east sides of the new building. And no longer requiring unnecessary parking spaces, along with the elimination of the adjacent landscape in the current plan, would allow the ambulance lane to more closely track the building perimeter and would very dramatically decrease the need to impose the construction on the existing forest. I move to postpone this matter to the week of April 5th to allow the Planning Commission and Board of Control to consider this amended variance and plan. I'd love a second, even just for the purpose of discussion.
Okay,
so I guess with that, if nobody's willing to second for the purpose of discussion, I'll close this statement with, I guess, just the sentiment that we have been very clearly communicated to by our residents. I think that if this sentiment had been clearly understood on the part of the administration and communicated to the applicant, or even after the March 2nd meeting or the March 10th meeting, we had taken care to go back to the applicant and say, hey, let's creatively figure this out. Let's reconfigure some of this parking. Maybe some of this lawn that you're creating is unnecessary on the east and north side of the new building. We could have been creative. I don't understand the haste with which we are pursuing this. This really does fly in the face of regular order. And I don't understand why.
Mike.
So I don't think this flies in the face of anything, regular order or not. If you want to talk about the regular order of things, there is usually a high degree of deference paid appropriately. So paid by this city council to the planning commission, paid by this city council to architectural board of review, paid by this city council to the board of control, and paid by this city council to our excellent planning staff and others, and every single board or commission that I just referenced, as well as our planning staff, is recommending to us that we approve this. And we move forward with this excellent project. That is after a lot of discussions with a very cooperative counterparty in the form of MetroHealth. I think they've been terrific partners in this process, and there's been a lot of discussion. As we all know, I don't remember exact time. Staff does. Planning Commission's last meeting went well into the night, and there are a ton of conditions that accompanied that Planning Commission recommendation, further supplemented in a rather robust way, as Councilwoman Russell noted earlier, with the excellent amendment that was added by Councilmember Hart. So, you know, I don't have any concern about this. I don't think that there's a single member of council that embraces or likes the idea of cutting down a tree if a tree doesn't have to be cut down. So you know, and I know there were some somewhat very few, though, but a few insulting suggestions that council members were abdicating their responsibilities by the way we were handling this. And I just don't think that's correct. And I don't think by voting for it, I'm in any way suggesting that that green initiatives aren't important to me. And I don't think anybody else intends to send that message either. But this is a terrific opportunity for our community, as Council Member Dunbar said articulately earlier. I think that MetroHealth could have gone to any community in Northeast Ohio and presented this opportunity, and any community that didn't grab it fast would be out of their minds. And we here in Cleveland Heights are not out of our minds. So I couldn't disagree more with Council Member Sarin on the setup. That's why I didn't second any request for delay or continuance. I don't think things have been rushed along. In fact, I wish every applicant that came into Cleveland Heights did business the way MetroHealth has done business. I think they've been profoundly tactful in the way they've approached this, and very, very respectful of not only our professional staff, but most importantly of our citizens. And the last thing I just want to say is, you know, I'm very proud. I think the kind of community that we should all be concerned about is the one that says, I don't give a darn about any of this. The fact that we had to sit here, I know it might've been a little painful. Jason was very courteous in not saying this earlier, which is I read almost every single one that was stated. So that was read to us. I read every single email I got. I thought they were beautifully written for the most part, extraordinarily thoughtful. I think they're an attestation of the type of community that we live in, that people care so deeply, you know, care about the MetroHealth facility and the expansion of the MetroHealth facility, yet at the same time care deeply about our woods and our buffers and our green space and all that. And I applaud that. And just because I'm voting for this project doesn't mean that I don't care about it either. And I won't dare to speak for others on council, but I suspect that I'm not alone in that regard. But rush job, no way. This isn't a rush job, and there's no reason to continue it. Thank you.
I just want to say, and my not seconding it, it was that I agree with you, Khalil, but I agree with Melody, because I believe with her amendment to the resolution gives MetroHealth time to look at all variants of not cutting down as many trees, or to look at what you have suggested as well, but also to move forward, because the parking lots are the last things that's going to have to be built, and there's going to be time for more discussion, more negotiations, and to find out what type of trees, or if they need to move, cut down trees, or if they can save the trees. Because I am all for saving the trees that are in that community, but I am also for moving forward with that, because most of the people I've talked to, even emailed back, they are for the development of Metro, and they want to move forward, but the issue is the trees. And I think we still have time to go let them move forward and still discuss further regarding the lots, as you suggested.
Just for,
so that was my perspective on not voting no, but just to, I think we should move forward with it, but still have more discussion about the trees and the parking lot.
Thank you, Davida. I appreciate that. Just for clarification, I did want to mention that this will be a phased construction. I believe the first phase is the clearing of trees to make way for the ambulance run, so that the travel of the ambulances is not interfered with by the construction during this construction period. So the first step will be clearing these trees.
A Melody. You're on mute.
When I heard about the expansion of MetroHealth, I was excited. I think there's a lot of pluses. I think it's great for Severance and could attract other healthcare providers. It's great for the city, and it's great for those needing the help that the facility will provide. I've gotten a lot of emails, and my job as this council member is to listen to the residents and to do what's best for the city. There were neighbors concerned about safety, and those concerns are being addressed by MetroHealth. And nevertheless, I'll work with neighbors, as I have with the Buckingham Building residents, to ensure the concerns are addressed. There's residents concerned about trees and worried about the tree canopy. A portion of the trees will be replaced, though not in the same place, and certainly they won't be as large. And we have an ocean of parking that is owned by NAMDAR. MetroHealth has been trying to work with us on concerns. And by the way, Khalil, I did not second yours because we're in the discussion period anyway. So, you know, you've opened up the discussion and we can discuss during this discussion period. Anyway, so MetroHealth has removed 300 parking places, which saves a lot of trees. And the 150-foot buffer is not going to be touched. Ultimately, I want to point out that these trees are owned by Metro, just as you own the trees on your property. And so ultimately, they could have actually cut them down before they came to us, since it's their trees. Now, fortunately, we're putting some restrictions on that, and that is a benefit because they came to us, to the Planning Commission, to try to get approval. So we have the series of restrictions, which includes replacing trees. And that's what the amending resolution allows them to continue to find ways, because they are not, and it does say that they need to investigate it. It is a condition, so therefore they do need to do that. As I said, I'm here to vote for what I believe is right for the city. This project has severance looking up, and I think that's what we want. It's one step, but it's one that could encourage more. And people in our city need help now. This will provide much needed treatment for families in crisis. I feel the project needs to move ahead now, but with the added language, it obligates them to look at alternatives. And so I feel that it is a good compromise.
Mary.
Let me just add quickly that if you want to do something positive about trees in our city, I've moved to a new house almost a little over a year ago now, and this past winter a dogwood got blown over and had to be removed. So the Heights tree people are providing me with a new tree. They came over today and have told me what they'll give me, and there were many nice options. So if you want to help with the tree canopy and you need a tree, talk to the Heights tree people. They have a website you can look up.
Thank you. I received a letter earlier today from Dr. Boutros, the CEO of MetroHealth, that I shared with my council colleagues and I'd like to share with the public. It reads, "Dear Mayor Stein, I am very appreciative of the time that the City of Cleveland Heights, its planning staff, Planning Commission, the Board of Control, and the Architectural Board of Review has spent reviewing our proposal to build a $42 million behavioral health hospital on the MetroHealth system's existing Severn Circle campus. I also appreciate the sincere concerns voiced by residents about safety and about the removal of a small portion of the trees on our property to accommodate the hospital and a vital ambulance roadway. We have listened carefully to those concerns and addressed them in multiple public forums. As Chief Mecklenburg concluded and reported to the Planning Commission, the new hospital will be very secure and the community as a whole will be safer because people who have behavioral health problems will get the treatment they need. As for the woods, if our designers thought it was possible to complete this project without touching a single tree, that's exactly what we would do. But it is not. We are already asking the city to let us open with nearly 300 fewer parking spaces than the current code would require, because we don't want to remove any more of the forest than we absolutely need to. And we made that decision without being asked by residents or the city, because we do care about the environment on our campus. Now it is time for City Council to decide whether this project goes forward. Simply put, we need a decision at Wednesday's meeting. We are on a very tight schedule. Our new main campus hospital opens in October of 2022. The behavioral health hospital must open at the same time. if work in Cleveland Heights does not begin immediately, we will likely miss that deadline, and that would be tragic for our patients and the entire Cuyahoga County community. Please don't lose sight of the bigger vision here, the need to dramatically expand the number of behavioral health and addiction services in Cuyahoga County and give more of our neighbors, our friends, and our family members the compassionate care they need and deserve. We are going to save lives with this new hospital, and we want to do it in Cleveland Heights. But if that is going to happen, we need your support now. Sincerely, Akram Boutros, MD, President and Chief Executive Officer of MetroHealth.
Jason, I'm sorry. I could be wrong, but it appears to me that I don't think a lot of residents realize that all of the trees that we're talking about is actually belongs to Metro and is on their property. And they could have cut those trees down without coming to us at all. So they are willing to work and compromise with us. So I think with Khalil's suggestion and Melody's suggestion moving forward, they would still be willing to compromise and work with us to be able to alleviate cutting down as few of trees or if no trees as possible.
Agreed. Metro's expansion and investment of $42 million into Cleveland Heights and specifically at Severance is a huge win for Cleveland Heights. This will bring good paying jobs, hundreds of thousands in new tax revenue, and I believe will be a springboard to additional interest and reimagining of Severance. At least equally important, this behavioral health hospital is needed, as Dr. Boutros wrote in that letter. Please don't lose sight of the bigger vision here, the need to dramatically expand the number of behavioral health and addiction services in Cuyahoga County and to give more of our neighbors, our friends, and our family members the compassionate care they need and deserve. We are going to save lives with this new hospital, and we want to do it in Cleveland Heights. Mrs. Himmelein, please call the roll.
Russell.
Aye.
Sarin.
I think this project is desperately needed, and I feel terrible that I can't vote yes on it. No.
Stein.
Aye.
Unger.
Aye.
Dunbar.
Aye.
Hart.
Aye.
Five ayes and one nay, Your Honor.
Okay, it passes. Now
my aye, I think my aye, along with everyone else's aye, is contingent while we continue to talk to Metro about whatever we can do about those trees.
All I can say, my eye is not contingent. All the conditions are in the legislation.
I'm talking about moving forward, but to discuss.
Again, I accepted Melody's amendment, and yes, that's what it is.
That's what I'm saying, Mike. Okay. That's what I'm saying. Thank you.
Okay. I just want to be clear. Those are the only conditions on the applicant.
Okay.
Thank you.
Okay, now do I have a motion to move into executive session to discuss with an attorney for the public body claims or disputes involving the public body that are the subject of a pending court action? Is there a motion?
So moved.
Second.
Okay. Mrs. Himmelein, please call the roll.
Sarin.
Aye.
Stein.
Aye.
Unger.
Aye.
Dunbar.
Aye.
Hart.
Aye.
Russell.
Aye.
Six ayes, Your Honor.
Okay, before we go offline, for anyone watching, you do not need to stay on. When we come back, we are going to come back out of executive session, whenever that may be in the future. But all it will be is for adjournment. We're not going to make any statements at that time. So if you want to stay on and watch that, that's fine, but you don't have to. There's no further discussion going on this video.
We are now back in regular session, Your Honor. You're on mute.
Okay, I've done that too many times. I think I did that the other night too. I exited already. All right, this meeting is adjourned. Have a good night, everyone.